Hi everyone, thanks so much for being here. My name is Kat and I make houseplant videos here on Good and Planty. If you just so happen to absolutely love this video, please consider liking, commenting, subscribing, or following me on Instagram. All of these things help me grow my channel like a plant. Today we are going to be talking all about the coffee plant, otherwise known as Coffee Arabica. We are going to talk all about water, soil, light, humidity, temperature, all that good stuff so that you can take the best care of your coffee plant indoors. I'm going to start off with a little bit of background info on this plant just because I find it to be super relevant to it. Please excuse my pronunciations this video. I'm trying my best. So Arabica is one species within the genus of Coffee. And there are about 60 to 100 different species alongside Arabica. Out of all of those species, two make up majority of the coffee that we drink. That would be Robusta and Arabica. And Arabica is definitely the most commonly produced coffee in the world. In terms of the world's coffee production, I think it actually makes up about 60 to 80%. So yes, this plant is Coffee Arabica and it can produce coffee beans that you can drink. These plants are tropical, so you will absolutely be seeing that in their care. So this plant is pretty unique because it is a plant that some people grow just to be an indoor house plant for its foliage, you know, just because it looks good. And then there's another group of people who want to grow it to produce coffee for themselves. The care for these two different circumstances can absolutely vary. So today I'm going to focus on growing probably a smaller coffee plant that is just for, I don't know, aesthetic indoor houseplant purposes. I've seen a lot of videos talk about how to produce beans and flowers with this plant, but I haven't seen too many on how to take care of it just as a houseplant. So that's why I'm making this video. And the good news for you is that if you want to grow this as a houseplant, it should be a little bit easier than if you were trying to produce beans. So let's start with water. These plants love water. You don't want to keep these plants soggy, otherwise they will begin to rot, but expect to keep this plant fairly moist almost throughout the entire year. During the winter time, you're definitely gonna be cutting back on water, but we'll get there. So if you don't have a moisture meter, I would wait for about the first 1 to 2 inches of soil to be dry before you go ahead and water. But if you are using a moisture meter like I do, I wait for the moisture meter to read at about a 3 until I go ahead and water it. This plant I can tell is thirsty without even using a moisture meter because these plants are pretty vocal. The pot for one is very light. I know what this pot feels like when it's properly watered, I guess. And you can see that the leaves are slowly starting to droop down. Usually the leaves are a little bit more perky, so that's another way to tell if your coffee plant needs water. However, I don't really recommend waiting for the plant to get extremely droopy every time. Otherwise, you're gonna see some of the signs of consistent underwatering. Whatever watering method you are using, you will notice that during the winter months, this plant does slow down and will require less water. So I am watering this plant a lot less than I normally would in the summertime because it is winter right now. I do like to water with distilled water for this plant. I am pretty sure that the root system can be a little bit sensitive to tap water. I am not a 100% distilled waterer with this plant, but I really try to give it not tap water pretty much because then you might see some burning of the leaves. So if you water this plant too much, you will definitely be seeing signs of root rot, and I now have a full video on root rot that I can refer you to, so it will be linked up above. And if you are not watering this plant enough, you will definitely see a lot of drooping and pretty dehydrated leaves and root system. Now let's talk about light. These plants love bright, indirect light. In the wild, they do love sunlight, but they tend to grow underneath other trees. And when they're grown commercially, usually they have some kind of shading system set for these plants because the foliage can burn pretty easily. Indoors, this plant can actually be kept pretty close to a window because even right directly next to a window indoors does not even come close to full sun outside, so windows are a pretty good bet for this plant. I would say ideally east or west facing windows is good for this plant, and if you have maybe a sheer curtain or a tree outside to kind of shade off the light a little bit, that would be like very ideal for this plant, but do the best that you can. But this plant is not low light tolerant, I will say that. If this plant does start getting too much light though, like I said, you will see some burning of the leaves, probably in like little circles. I think I actually pruned off all of the light damage that I recently had. And in the worst case scenario, you might even experience some leaf loss. If that happens, that's totally fine. The plant will bounce back. Just make sure that you move it into a little bit more indirect light. Soil and repotting. For this plant, I have seen quite a few articles and places and people mentioning the acidity of the soil and how much this plant just absolutely loves acidity in the soil, how you should be using a certain amount of peat moss and you should be using a pH reader. And I'm here to tell you that honestly, maybe that matters more for growing it for beans, but as a houseplant, I really haven't noticed any difference in not paying attention to the acidity literally at all. If you want to go ahead and do extra research on maintaining the correct level of acidity for this plant, please feel free, go ahead. Maybe it'll give your plant like superpowers or something. But honestly, for me, I have not noticed any problems with just going with the regular potting soil I use for the rest of my plants. The only tweak maybe I do is I add a little bit less drainage for this plant because it does like to have moist soil, so it's not really as necessary to have a boatload of perlite or pumice in the mix. For the pot, I generally try to stick with these white terracotta pots because I personally have found them to retain a little bit more moisture than your standard terracotta pots. That's just my experience. Or if you don't have white terracotta pots, they can be a little bit more expensive. I would just stick to a good old nursery pot. You can also go ceramic, but those are a little bit harder to find with proper drainage holes. When you are repotting, just go up an inch, maybe two max in pot size, because you really don't want to overwhelm this plant with soil. The root system is not crazy strong, so you might actually find root rot if you jump to too big of a pot size. Humidity and temperature. So this is going to be a very short and sweet section. These plants are tropical, so honestly, the care shouldn't be that surprising. They do like warmer temperatures, so think like 70 to 80 degrees Fahrenheit. Some houses I know go slightly colder than that. Sometimes my house does, and I haven't noticed a huge issue in going to like 65 degrees maybe, but I would try to stick to a little bit warmer of a temp. They do like high humidity, so I would try to keep like at least 60% humidity around them. This plant right now isn't near a humidifier, and I don't see huge issues, but I think I would have a little bit healthier growth if it were to be closer to the humidifier. And of course, keep this plant away from any hot or cold drafts like windows, doors, vents, all that. Fertilizer. So as with most other plants, you are going to want to fertilize this plant during the growing season or when you see it growing fairly aggressively. I would say for this plant, it's better to use a little bit of a more gentle organic fertilizer and water more frequently than hit it with a strong synthetic fertilizer, just because it is a little bit sensitive and you might end up over fertilizing and burning the leaves. The leaves, if you cannot tell, burn quite easily, so just be a little bit mindful of that. I use, are you ready? If you are a subscriber that watches all of my videos, I use Espoma's all-purpose balanced organic fertilizer. I dilute it in the water during the spring and summer months, and I just water this plant as usual. I probably do that once every week or 2 weeks. It's a pretty gentle fertilizer, so I'm not really worried about over-fertilizing the plant. And the last thing I want to say about this plant is actually a pest note, which I usually don't talk about in my care videos because pests are such a complex and deep topic. I don't want to smush all of that information in a care video, but just be careful because these plants, like a lot of other plants that people grow for food, are prone to attracting pests. So make sure that you are cleaning the leaves, you are using your preventative neem oil, and all that, because honestly, I have had some pest issues with this plant. Luckily, nothing too serious, but just make sure you're keeping an eye out for ugly bugs. Thank you all so much for watching my video. I hope you learned a little bit about the coffee plant, how to take a little bit better care of it, and some background info on this plant. If you have any additional care tips, please feel free to drop them down below. I'm sure other people, including myself, will find them useful. And if you have any questions about this plant, I will do my best to answer them. Please subscribe if you don't already and you want to see more planty content from me, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!